हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल सी अ प्रॉब्लम ऑन कॉनिकल हेलिक्स। फॉर आवर पर्पस वी हैव टू सी द प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट। ड्रॉ अ कॉनिकल हेलिक्स ऑफ वन रोटेशन ऑफ सरफेस ऑफ कोन ऑफ बेस डायमीटर 60 mm एंड एक्सिस हाइट इज 80 mm। दे हैव गिवन द कंडीशन व्हेन द पिच इज इक्वल टू हाइट ऑफ द कोन। सो एज फॉर दिस प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट आई विल राइट द गिवन डेटा। इन दैट गिवन डेटा दे हैव गिवन द डी डायमीटर ऑफ दैट कोन इज 60 mm एंड एक्सिस हाइट इज 80 mm। सो एज पर दिस प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट आई विल ड्रॉ द कोन। सो दे हैव गिवन द डायमीटर ऑफ 60 mm। सो आई हैव टू टेक रेडियस। सो आई हैव टू टेक रेडियस ऑफ 30 mm इन कंपास। And by this 30 mm radius, I have to draw a circle. So here, I have drawn a circle of 30 mm radius. Now this circle, we have to divide into 8 parts. Now this circle is divided into 4 parts. Next step is we have to divide two sectors in 45 degree angle. So with the help of protractor we have to divide these 2 sectors. Right side 45 degree and left side 45 degree. Then these points we have to join with center. Now this circle is divided into 8 parts. So as for procedure, I will give naming to all these divided sectors. So this will be, I will give name to P, or you can say 0 also. So here this will be 1 number, this will be 2, this will be 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and last it will be 8. So here this circle is divided into 8 parts as per procedure. And then we have to take a projection of this circle, because if we will view this cone in top view, that cone will look like circle. So in top view we are drawing this cone as a circle, and then we have to take projection. Okay, now I have taken all projection into a front view. So I will draw a horizontal line or base. So I have drawn the base in front view, that base will be look like straight line, and in front view total cone will look like a triangle. So next step is we have to transfer the axis of this cone. So I will transfer the axis. Then they have given the axis height in the problem statement. They have given the base diameter 60 and axis height is 80 mm. So I will transfer this axis height on that axis is 80 mm. So here from that base, that axis height is 80. Okay, so I will join this base with the apex with the help of generator. Now in front view this cone will be look like a triangle. Now next step is what? Next step, we have to transfer all projection of top view into a front view. So I will transfer the projection of this 1 and 7 into a front view. Next 3 and 5 I will transfer into a front view. Okay, now we have to join this all projection to apex with the help of generator. So I will join with the help of scale. Okay, so that affix name is O, and here now next step is what? We have to divide this slant or this generator, incline generator, by 8 parts, because this circle is divided into 8 parts, so this generator should be a divided 8 parts for one revolution. कितने रिवोल्यूशन के लिए? फॉर वन रिवोल्यूशन वी हैव टू डिवाइड इन टू 8 पार्ट्स. सो हियर एज फॉर प्रोसीजर व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल डिवाइड दिस जनरेटेड इन टू 8 पार्ट्स. फॉर दैट पर्पज आई विल टेक इंक्लाइन लाइन फ्रॉम बेस एंड आई विल डिवाइड दिस इन टू 8 पार्ट्स. Now we have to join last point with the apex. Last point with the apex. So here 1, this will be the 2, this will be 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so all projection I have transferred. Now I will give naming to these points. So this will be the 0, this will be 1, this will be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and last point is 8 point. So as per procedure, we have to take a projection of these points in horizontal line. So parallel to horizontal or parallel to base, we have to take all projections. So first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and last will be the 8th. So all projections we have taken in horizontal line. So as for procedure, we have to go into top view and we have to see the points which will be the visible. So here our curve will be start from this point P, so or 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. All these points will be visible because these all points are in front view. So in front view all points will be the dark points, and behind this circle, semicircle will be look like what? A hidden, or that will be a dotted. So here the will take points for intersection of this vertical and horizontal line. So I will start from first point O because our curve will be start from here. Next, one number vertical line will be intersect with one number horizontal line. Here we'll get second point. Next, two number vertical line will be get intersect with two number horizontal line. We'll get third point here. Three number in vertical line will be intersect with three number horizontal line. We'll get point here. Next, four number vertical line will be get intersect with four number horizontal line. We'll get point here. Next, five number vertical line will be intersect with five number horizontal line. We'll get next point here. Six number vertical line will be intersect with six number horizontal line. Seven number vertical line will be intersect with seven number horizontal line, and eight number vertical line will be intersect with eight number horizontal point. So last point will be here. So we'll draw this curve. First I will give naming. So this will be the P0, this will be P1, this will be P2, this will be P3, this will be P4, this will be P5, this will be P6, this will be P7, and this will be the P8. So one by one I will give naming and I will join these points. So P0 to P1 it will be dark, because 0 to 1 dark, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4 till this will get dark. So P1 to P2 is also dark, P2 to P3 is also dark, P3 to P4 is also dark. Okay, after P4 that all points will be the dotted points because these points are behind this circle. So P4 to P5 this will be the dark dotted, P5 to P6 also dotted, P6 to P7 is also dotted, and P7 to P8 is dotted. So likewise, the our helix will be get completed. So this will be what? Our helix. So next part is, when we will view from top view to this cone, what we will look? We will look this circle. Along with that, this helix will be look like another type of curve. So that type of curve is known as Archimedean spiral. So in top view, we will view this is Archimedean spiral. So next step is what? We have to take projection. So here we will see, this is what? This will be R0 radius. R0 radius of what? This will be the radius of this circle. So next, R1, we'll take the project distance R1 from generator to axis to generator. Next, R3, this will be the radius 3. This is the distance from axis to generator. This will be R2, this will be R3. That is also distance from axis to generator. R4, distance from axis to generator. R5, distance from axis to generator. R6, that is the also distance from axis to generator. This will be R6. That distance is also R7. And this R8 will be the point. So that R8 has no distance. So all these radiuses are required to plot a spiral in top view. So here, as per procedure, we have taken given the radius R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6, R7 and R8. Now we have to project these all radiuses on that circle. So for that purpose, first you have to take that R0 radius in compass and mark here. So your curve will be start from here. So R1 will be here, R0 will be here. Next, we have to take distance in compass. R1 distance in compass and come on number 1 line and mark here. Next, take R3 distance in compass. R3 distance, that distance is from axis to incline generator. Here R3, take that distance in compass. Mark on there. Then R4, take that R4 distance in compass. Mark on 4 number radius. Take R5 distance in compass. Mark on 5 number line. Take R6 distance in compass. Mark on 6 number line. Take R7 distance in compass. Take that distance in compass. Now I have to measure that distance, because that distance is little bit. So that is 4 mm. So that 4 mm you have to mark here. And last, R8 will be at center. So here, if you will see, so I have marked all distances on that lines. So I have to join this, or I have to first give naming to this. This will be R1, this will be R2, this will be R3, this will be R4, this will be R5, this will be R6, and last one will be the R8. So I have to join these all points smoothly. 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7, and 7 to